Potato. 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 Think that works better. Hi. Hi. Close that. Okay. So, horror, spooks, let's go. I really should, like, you know, put my alert out in a bunch of Twitter discords, but bleh. That's like what? If people turn up, people turn up. Let's go. Aye, aye, boss lady. Game is spooky. Something smashed the window. This game is actually creepy AF. Can't see shh. By the way. With that attitude, I might. kind of idiot does a cult shit in a house like this? Thanks, spooky game. Oh, okay. Water. Wind. Fire. Something else. Earth. Thank you. It is a spoopy. Hi, Kayvan. Hey, Fro. Sorry I didn't see you guys pop in. This is called Don't Knock Twice. It is a spooper, or is supposed to be a spooper. Oh no, the piano's playing itself. Give me back my axe. I'm probably supposed to be reading these things and like focusing on them and be all like, oh wow, the girl has the thingamabob. No one cares. Where was I going? Oh yeah. This way? Okay. Spooky steam. Woo! Wait, can I smash this one? You have a lock. Yeah! For safekeeping, duck is in the fire. Can't lock the door on me if you've got no door handle. I don't know what I'm actually doing. Ow, that hurt my face. Okay. Classic. No, don't drop my hatchet. Where'd it go? Hey, spooky baby. Bro, are you trying to get me killed? Oh, no! Is my hatchet over here? Clipping through the wall. Can't see crap, by the way. That didn't help at all. There's still zero brightness. Hey, that's a cool emote. They all got approved. Well, I am mildly concerned. I lost my axe. Pretty sure I'm stuffed. Gross. I'm pretty sure I need my hatchet. Good to know. If I said you can keep a ghostie, would that make you happy? I don't know who you're actually talking about. This game is a spoopa. Pretty sure I'm incidentally screwed. Oh, man. I'm legit screwed. You're mine, okay. I dropped a hatchet and now it's gone. And I need it to unlock all the doors. And I'm looking around. Yeah, because look. Can left click to throw it or throw things. It was on the table. Was here with a hatchet. Handle broke off. I went this way, broke through this wall, went this way. Unlocked this. Went in here. Walked down here, picked up a thing here, and as I picked it up, dropped the hatchet in here somewhere, and now I'm dead. Or screwed. I literally can't progress, I'm pretty sure. I also turned the gamma and brightness way up. So stream can see things. Bird seed, bird feed. That okay, I'll just go pick things up and do things. Right, that should work. Yeah. That's all closed off. That's all closed off. Oh, look, bloody handprints. There, let's follow them. Locked. Candle. Locked. Locked. Non-reflective. There was a ghost in here, or a ghost event. So yeah. am 90% certain that I've forked myself. Alright, let's see if reloading the save will get it back. Because, yeah. Well done. I'm super smart. Oh, hi, Ghosty. Yay! I am so smart. I am so smart. Everybody hates me because I am so smart. Need to find more Matryoshka doll. No door handles for you, jerk butt. Game doesn't know what to do. Anyway, I am so smart. I am so smart. SMRT. I mean, SMART. I am so smart. Fuck you and your door hand. Also, this is far less frightening with all the lights up, but also way better for stream to actually see what's going on. Cool. Spoopy. Ooh, say. Ooh, another hatchet. It's everywhere. The only way the server can free of the demon is if they kill themselves or trick someone else into replacing them by doing something truly evil. So fighting Baba Yaga. Right. Hello, television. Basement, basement. I kind of wish this person would just clean their house. Ooh, ooh, can I get a jump scare? Aww. Basketball. So much effort just to play sports. Whoa. What was I doing? Or 8-6-2. Hydrate. Can do, Mikey. What's next? confused. I'm lost as to what to do. I'm lost. I'm lost. Confused. Also concerned I broke something again. Wasn't on purpose this time. Like, I'd be like okay with it if, like, yeah, I was trying to break it, but accidentally left clicking and then dropping a key item and then losing it forever. Like, that's a new one even for me. But the only thing I can think of Why did I take the head? Rawr. Goes upstairs. Anyone got any ideas? I'm not even getting spooky events anymore. Which was like what was leading me to places. I was like, well, now what? All spooky events. Back the stones to unlock the tiara. I had a cooker, undead heart. That was the hint for the kitchen. I'm not gonna Google it. Oh my god! Where's an axe? Upstairs. The piano has a lock on it. That's odd. What's odd? What's odd? I think it's coming back for you. Whoa. This is where a jump scare was earlier. This. Well, now what? Everything's on fire. Don't knock twice. Right, enough once. I think I made a mistake. Run! Because we're not stupid. We're not. I don't know. Made a mistake by knocking twice. That certainly was a game. Hi, I need that game was called Don't Knock Twice, and it's a horror title a psychological terrifying urban legend. It's the Baba Yaga curse. In short, but basically you start the game, you're in a house, you get a text from someone you don't know at this point named Chloe, and then you explore the house, solve some puzzles, and from the looks of it, kill Chloe. Sorry if that spoils the game, but I'm kind of now at a loss of to what to do. Because I thought that was going to be a bit longer, so any any specific requests that I might have? Oh, actually, I don't know if this one's any good, so let's go Absolov. Make sure. Alright, so I haven't actually set this one up yet, so this might be really, really loud, and I do apologize. Add new source. Minimize that. Let's see if escape will work. It might have crashed. It seems to have crashed. Definitely crashed. Let's try that again. All right. So this is another horror title that I have called Absolov, End of Gods. I know very little about it. A lot of these games have a tendency to just 100% blow your head off volume because they're like, oh, if we play a loud noise, you'll get a jump scare, right? Whoa, okay. This is... I'm gonna play on normal. This has multiple difficulty settings, which I was not expecting.
Slightly limped. Her responses and her cognitive abilities seem to work pleasantly. Good morning, my dear. No, it's not strange. Still not weak, I see. No, I'm surprising.
Who are you?
Repeat that, my dear. I didn't quite catch it.
Who are you? Where am I?
It seems your throat muscles need some time to recover. I'll fix that for you later. Otherwise, this whole procedure would have been a waste of my precious time. Let us continue. Can you see the light? There's something waiting for me there. Let's remember the numbers. 1, 4, 3, 6. Good. Now, over to the next light. That's the lock. Find the key, then unlock it. There you go. Now, over to the last light.
Where am I?
Stop talking already. I can't understand you before your tongue has been unclogged. So stop talking! This is unseen light. This happened. Oh, no. Oh, no. This is happening. There you are. Now you can see what we see. Stop acting out before you become stronger and use your gifts.
No! What the? to me.
Shut up! I cannot understand you. Stop straining you already went through human adversity. If that happens, then you are useless to me, and I would be forced to give you some breakfast on the meal. Not even worthy of being incinerated. Now, use that gift that I granted you, and choose your side. Show me who you are. Yes, this is perfect, my dear. I knew you would be perfect. My perfect creation. Everything is perfect. Everything will finally restore you.
Hey, Shadow, what's going on? What the hell? That's supposed to Absolov, End of Gods. I literally found it and just started playing. Because we played Don't Knock Twice already. Finished it, and that was pretty weird. Had some scares, but I wouldn't really say scary, like, but you're talking to the wrong person. Predictable, some other people don't. So, this is a sequel? Okay. That's probably why I don't understand. A sequel to something else? Absalom something else? Probably.
Waste of life that you are, you decided to leave my merciful embrace. A decision you will regret in the dark.
This has been entertaining so far. Like, you're literally watching like the first, 15 minutes of it. We've got sight. We've got a spooky location. We've got a jump key. If I understand this game at any point, I'll let you know. Hi, Mrs. Shadow. Really? It was just a dude. This might be a good game for you to play on your stream. If that scared you. Actually, don't knock twice would be great for you.
I've been leading my team to go through the routes to fetch artifacts for Vorkorp for over 3 months now. I know it's not my place to question my orders, but I can no longer deem transportation through the routes as safe. It wasn't a problem when I thought the Underworlds were inhabited and dead, but last time Team 4 went through, we were fully armed, and still only half of us came back. And these roots, they're still spreading. Before the power of the gods, we are nothing.
Ow. That? Why would you do that? Obviously, you did that on purpose. No, I can just start running and jumping into places.
Do you see? She left because she hates you. She left you all alone here. If you don't want to be alone forever, you need to get her back from me. Can you do that? No. Make your father proud.
What's up?
Stupid, disgusting creature.
This is Drugo. Join. There's a giveaway. I'm pretty sure currently it's only Shadow. I need to actually let me grab these. What is that better? The game is loud. I'll drop the game a bit and I'll increase myself. How about now? Is game loud enough or soft enough?
Dr. Lisa Svensson, supervisor, day 3 of Tablet Analysis. We received several stone tablets from Front Alfheim with inscriptions apparently symbolizing the 9 realms of the World Tree. Initial analysis shows that the tablet emits an energy field boosting cell regeneration. End of note. Research note 6. The expeditions to Asgard have proven fruitful yet again. The team brought back several shields that seem to possess a number of strange capabilities which are completely out of our control. According to the myth, these shields seem to have belonged to the winged creatures known as Valkyries. The mission of these creatures were to bring dead warriors to an afterlife in Valhalla, and must have possessed enormous powers.
Yeah. find my key.
Hi. Found a puppy.
Pathology research, note one. Sarah has shown me a lot of the myths surrounding the ancient objects we have recovered. Just like assumed, most of these stories corresponds only a little with the true events of the past. Giants and fire giants are very much like the descriptions, but the Vanir and Aesir gods differ a lot from their noble fairy tale versions. Some stories are not even close to as gruesome as they are in real life. More of these stories later.
マイケイブシーマンセズヘイドルインクスキッキング壊れるハート壊れるハート壊れるハート as usual.
Kicking ass as usual. For various definitions, yes. Random Japanese, like, card. I just lost an arm to spider people. What the hell?
If I would have been 5 seconds late, the demons would have torn you apart.
The great Odin spared your life, but left you broken. But that's okay, because I fixed you. No, you know what? I made you better. Remarkable, isn't it?
What?
No, 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 you stay down. The anesthetics haven't left your system yet.
Oh, my head.
Okay, let's see here. Speech should be fine. I prepared the tissue. Yeah, I gave the bone structure a checkup as well. And the arm? How does it feel? Strange feeling, isn't it? When it's bonding to you. I know. I have a few of my own. Anyway,
I don't like this guy.
I have much to prepare. You rest for now.
Henrik, look at her. It's Alice.
The injuries she suffered and survived. It's not human.
That doesn't mean she's not.
Who are you?
By Odin.
My voice.
She even sounds like. Yes. Yes. I fixed your voice. And your arm.
Who are you? What's going on?
I'm Henrik Andersen, the CEO of Bohr Corp. The voice you're hearing is my wife, Sarah. She's up on the surface, Ralph.
Unfortunately.
You and I are stuck down here.
The things happening down there are happening up here as well. And it's getting worse by the minute.
What did you do to me?
I brought you back from Helheim.
Henrik, calm down. The journey to save her almost killed you. I don't want to lose you. Since she already has the prosthetic, tell her about it.
Fine. Your new arm holds great power. Charged by Atrium, it can channel a magnificent force. It's based upon ancient knowledge uncovered by my wife.
And brought into fruition by Henrik. The arm is called Jerngreipur.
You brought a hand with you. Use the Jerngreipur to extract the RFID from it. You'll gain access to all doors with that level of security clearance. Now try it. Scan the hand on the table, and then use it downstairs on the lock.
I know this is a lot to ask. We're not taking this lightly. Please. I'll tell you more as you go.
Too frequent. The roots are spreading faster. Please hurry. I'll show you all the things you need to know. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good. You can hear me as long as our radio can reach your Bifrost system. Ahead of you is your first obstacle. A service hatch that can usually only be opened from the inside, unless you're an engineer. However, Jerngreipur can open the tunnels in an unconventional way. But first, you need power. You should find an Atrium upgrade in a nearby room. That right there is a small Atrium cell that can power the arm. Insert it in the arm, get back to the service hatch, and fire a burst at it to fry the lock circuits. And don't forget to refill your power with the power station on the wall before you move on. If you collect enough upgrades for Jerngreipur, you can activate the weapon inside it. Ahead and above you, there's another obstacle you can overcome with Jerngreipur. Use your sight. Find the ladder's control panel, aim at it, and fire a directed burst to lower the ladder. Since Jerngreipur is relying on Atrium power cells, your life might be depending on not running out. There is another, larger power cell that you can carry with you at all times. Collect the power cells. Anytime you want to use them, activate your Bifrost personal display system for instructions and to keep track of how many you've collected. Ahead of you, you will find a door that is locked with an RFID signature you don't have. But now, that won't be a problem for you. It's the same as the earlier electronics, but the mechanics of the door needs a little finesse. Use your sight to see the mechanics inside the door and time the burst to get through.
Everything seems to be working again. Where were we? Right. Our world, Midgard, is sharing its existence with eight other worlds that are all connected by something known in the legends as Yggdrasil, the world tree.
When we started researching travel between worlds, we used technology to tap into a magical artifact known in the legends as the Absolon, controller of the roots of Yggdrasil. This made it possible for us to safely travel to other worlds. Then, something came through one of the roots. Spirit. To control the Astrovolv and our systems, causing an emergency override. The facility was completely sealed, and the roots started spreading.
We need to reverse this by collecting the 9 artifact keys originally made to control the artifact and the roots it brings forth. But, Henrik has traveled too much undetected. He almost died when he saved you, and wouldn't survive going through another route. You are literally our only hope of stopping this. Without those keys, the roots and nightmares will take over our world. The fire giants will...
Sarah!
Wait, Henrik, I'm losing connection again.
Sarah? Shit.
Listen, we know the location of one of the keys. Ahead of you is a route that will take you to Niflheim, the ice world. Every moment, the roots spread further into Midgard, so find the key and come back here as soon as possible. Please, hurry!
Dr. Brian Roberts, Niflheim Operations Supervisor. Minor progress report on Niflheim Outpost N502. Construction is moving along according to schedule. Procedures after the complete destruction of N498 are implemented and seems to be working. Building is strictly held to crevices. The amount of noise is held to a minimum, and outposts are working 24/7 to avoid the attention of the natives. However, the morale is very strained after the 48 casualties at N498. Worst of all are the sounds of the natives. It travels for miles through the infinite night and fog in this dead landscape. It just chills you to the core.
Thank you.
Spooky.
Back alive. As soon as we lost connection, I thought. I can see you on a camera feed. Ahead of you, in Absalov Research, there's an elevator that you can take to me on floor B1. I've marked the elevator so you can find it with your sight. There's probably a lot of things to explore in Absalov Research, but don't stay for too long. Don't insert the key into the tablet until I've analyzed it. Please hurry.
Research, note 4, with Dr. Henrik Andersen and my lovely wife.
Dr. Sarah Andersen.
The power of the hammer of the god is on a whole other level than anything discovered before. The hammer is powering the entire facility, and it's more stable than anything else of this strength. Even the power cells charged with it has a huge amount of power.
We've decided to call the power Atrium, after the creator of the hammer. Not only does Atrium have the attributes described by Henrik, it also has a lot of magical potential. I don't know how to describe the phenomena scientifically, but Atrium has a terrifying effect on certain creatures from the myth that are affiliated with darkness. When it was wielded by Thor, it must have had an enormous destructive capacity. No wonder the gods are described as feared by everyone in the Nine Realms. Research, note 5. There are many gods from the myths, which seem to have ties to the things we are retrieving from the other worlds. We have items from Odin, the Allfather, and his son Thor, the god of lightning. We have also found proof of the existence of the immortal father, Freya, the goddess of fertility. And we have some leads on Hel, the goddess of death. Ymir, the keeper of the Well of Wisdom, and Loki, the god of mischief. But that one worries me a bit. That is described in the Younger Edda doesn't seem to be a wall at all. It's a statue capable of shutting out the roots of Yggdrasil and opening them to the one in control of it. I fear that this statue is exactly what we have here in the facility. The Absolof. To find the artifacts that we need. That is, until now. Henrik found out that magical beings can see on a spectrum that is invisible to mere mortals. And with artifacts and knowledge brought home from Vanaheim, Henrik has managed to infuse this magic into an augmented reality implant, making the spectrum visible to the user. And this is an amazing leap forward to unlock the secrets that these worlds are holding from us.
Researcher Yang, Node 40. The Absolof containment facility has grown in equal proportions to the discoveries made during the last few months. The various spatial phenomena occurring in the vicinity of the Absolof are astounding, and the materials excavated are just... they're alien in nature and most likely dangerous. And I keep wondering about Dr. Henrik Anderson's intentions. It's clear he's looking for something. At first, I figured it to be a religious reasoning behind his actions. But when I came across a schedule for the facility, I noticed how Anderson has apparently moved his own daughter into one of the advanced care units. He's planning something. I want to find out what.
Save it here, and then we'll finish up because I'm getting tired.
This game is weird. Like, I want to continue, like, watching and playing weird. So, I'm going to save it here, I'm going to quit out, and I'm going to come back to this on another stream. Because I'm actually enjoying that. Now, is there anyone raidable? I'll drop everyone with new DNA. Oh, what's she doing? Drinking, I'll give rifle a raid. So rifle is a good friend. Been with him for a while. Thank you for watching, everyone. We're gonna raid now, and we'll catch you all later.